Until recently, Dwarka's history was only a matter of folklore. The question, is Dwarka real, was constantly asked. And now, there are archaeological findings which prove that there was a city of Dwarka in ancient times, which is now submerged deep underwater. Excavations at Dwarka commenced approximately a century ago in the 1930s near Bet Dwarka Island, roughly 30 kilometers north of present-day Dwarka in Gujarat's Jamnagar district. Then again, in 1979, the Archaeological Survey of India undertook another excavation campaign, during which pottery dating back to the 2nd millennium BC was unearthed. These findings were of a great deal for the ASI as they were the stepping stones for the future findings of Dwarka. Archaeologists discovered a building that appeared to be a fortified foundation, which is so similar to its description mentioned in the ancient text of Mahabharata. Now the big question is it just a mere coincidence or a revelation of facts? Not just this, more than 500 artifacts were excavated from this site, with certain samples and dating evidence strongly indicating a cultural succession spanning 2,000 years. Among the discoveries were stone blocks, pillars, and irrigation systems. However, the precise dating of these findings remain a subject of debate by many historians. Still, it was stated by renowned archaeologist of India, S.R. Rao, who led many teams credited with discoveries of various Harappan sites, including the port city of Lothal and Bet Dwarka in Gujarat, that all the findings of the underwater ancient city of Dwarka have proven its existence, which is dated around 1500 BC. According to yet another theory, the ancient city of Dwarka was built on the westernmost tip of India roughly around 3,500 years ago and got drowned in the sea because of frequent water level rises. Scientific studies have also proven this theory by stating that the sea levels of this region have risen and fallen many times to reach the level that it is today. And this could be because of geological disturbances or coastal erosions. To add more to this story, a large number of anchors were excavated underwater at this site, indicating that this area could have been a busy port in ancient times. And to your surprise, the word Dwarka in itself means a portal or a door in the Sanskrit language, which further confirms Dwarka being an ancient port city. Till now, we have known quite a few things about the ancient city of Dwarka. So now, let's get to know about the recent developments in this region of India. Recently, the Prime Minister of India inaugurated the Sudama Setu, dedicated to the Sant Sudama, who was the great friend of Dwarkadhish Shri Krishna. This pedestrian suspension bridge connects the island of Dwarka to the mainland. The beaches of this island provide magnificent sunset views along with the mesmerizing encounter of the River Gomti meeting the Arabian Sea. The whole environment of this place is filled with ancient glory, faith, and beliefs of the people. One cannot help but be captivated by the sheer beauty of Dwarka, the vibrant colors of the bustling markets and the serene ambience of its sacred sites evoke a sense of wonder and awe. Whether it's the intricately carved spires of the Dwarkadhish temple or the tranquil waters of the Gomti Ghat, each aspect of Dwarka's landscape portrays a timeless charm and leaves visitors spellbound. Moreover, the city's rich cultural heritage and spiritual significance add an extra layer of enchantment, making Dwarka a truly unforgettable destination for those who are fortunate enough to experience its beauties firsthand. With this, the story of Dwarka ends in this video, but not in real life. So until next time, let us continue to marvel at the timeless beauty and profound history of Dwarka that lie beneath the ever-changing waves of the ocean. Finding this story interesting? Then stay tuned with the Cognizant Crow for more such videos and never let your curiosity die.